Now I'm your big mole dropper, mud duck stopper, Fila on the bottom and Adidas on the topper. Transform stretching,
what up? Going back for all you old folks out there. Little buttermilk biscuits, here we go. How's everyone doing out there? How's you staying alive? Staying healthy? Got one day left. I'm going to Mabel Gray after the show tonight.
What's that?
It's one of my favorite restaurants. That and She Wolf. Those are my two restaurants I like to go to out here. But they're locking everything down starting tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. That's
for
right.
My safety.
Okay. Someone's got to protect
you.
So
much. Thank you for keeping me safe. I really appreciate it. Thank you for limiting my movement to keep me safe. Appreciate you.
You don't want to kill someone's grandma.
Fuck your grandma.
That's why you're not in charge.
There's a lot of reasons why I'm not in charge. let's be all the way real. There's a lot of reasons why I'm not in charge, but I'm for the, like, if you might get sick, you should stay inside, and then if you don't get sick, then you go outside. How's that?
Some agree with you. They're out there wreaking havoc on us all.
They looting or anything? Or are they just... Oh, I guess they're not wreaking that much havoc. I don't know why you're on their side, John. Don't you want to just work? Like, don't you just want to work?
I am working. I am working.
I'm sitting on the couch talking to a fucking wall. I'm looking at a beige wall right now.
I'm balling pretty hard over here with Rick Springfield in the other room. Look at me.
Yeah, you get to go to work. You finessed it where you can go to work. I don't get to go to work. I would love to sit down with you and Chris and Keenan. And have us bring in guests and do the show and shit like that and fucking be normal. But unfortunately, that's not going to happen for months.
It's coming around again. The light is at the end of the tunnel. I can see it.
They said they was locking down for 2 weeks, and that was fucking 8 months ago, bro. And then they just re-locked down again. Give me a fucking break, dog.
You're not wrong.
I got a right to be annoyed by this shit. And it looks like their tactic didn't work. Because here we go. Again, we're still locking down. Didn't work. Maybe you should try something new. I don't know shit. Hey, took me 5 years to graduate high school. What does the World Health Organization say? I don't even believe in them, but they don't even agree with this shit.
Well, they've got a handle on it up in Canada.
There's seven people in fucking Canada, man.
Look to the Canadians.
They locked it down, too, for 28 days.
Well, they're doing better than us.
It all depends. How many people are being tested?
I don't know. I'll have to call my street.
Like, there's so many fucking variables, bro. Little bit facing the wrong thing in your face. Bring that shit back to the beginning of this shit. Be like, oh my god, look at her butt. Look, bring that shit back. Turn.
My god, Becky, turn that look shit up. At her
bring
butt.
It back to the,
it
bring
is
it back
so
to
big.
Right.
Bring.
Oh my god, Becky, look at her butt. It is so big. She looks like one of those rap guys' girlfriends.
All right.
Who understands
this dropped,
those rap
this dropped in, like, I want to say 92, 93. And that was a joke. The way those women talk, that was a joke. If you go to California right now, that's how people actually talk. That's fucking, isn't that crazy?
I've met them.
They became caricatures. You can bring it down now. That's fucking, I remember the first time I was like, it was an Asian chick from the Valley, and she was talking. I was like, this motherfucking girl sound just like the fucking big butt shit. And it was her, a black girl and a white girl, and they all sounded like that. I was like, it broke my fucking brain. I'm like, God damn. All y'all sound fucking crazy. And that goes for the fucking women's faces and shit too. Like all of that shit that used to be a joke, now you're doing that to your face. You bitches look like Zoolander out in this motherfucker. Fucking duck lips and shit. It's not pretty. I'm just telling you. But what happens is you watch something so much, it normalizes it for you. And you're like, oh, I think I'm going to get fucking lip implants. If you're thinking about getting lip implants, ladies, let me tell you something. It feels like I'm kissing a fucking keloid. You know what a keloid is, John?
I don't. I've heard of it, but like,
how the fuck are you on a hip hop thing? God damn it, man.
Keloid. Oh, that's like a skin tag or something, or like a scar.
Skin tag.
All right.
It's a big ass bubble, hard and shit. That's what your lips feel like. I'm telling you, I kissed them before. They feel like shit. Don't do that to your lips. Even if you got some no lips like John, except for as soon as the Wuhan opens up, we're gonna get John some lip injections.
A modest example.
I can't wait for John to get lip injections. That's gonna be so fucking good, yo.
Yeah, when we were talking about it, some listeners called up who had it done. They said, it's no big deal, John. Don't worry about it. There were these women. They were convincing me it was a good idea. And they finally turned me around. Sure. Okay, fine. Let's do it.
See, it's not a big deal. It'll go away. Yeah. I'm just telling you, ladies, the shit's... It doesn't matter for John, because let's be real. He ain't going to kiss nobody. It doesn't matter.
It's bound to happen one day.
I don't think so, man.
I'm guaranteed. They're out there.
Come here, girl. Give me a kiss.
You know you want some of this?
That's me shucking my lips in. Hey, hey, what's up, baby? You're looking pretty good. I don't know if it's the Tangeray talking or what, but I really want to lick your pussy.
Here comes the tongue.
No lips, all tongue. hell no. All right, actually... we should play a song. We got Hung Young calling up. She was the one that we paid her to fuck you, and she didn't fuck you.
She was willing.
I know, but you busted a nut too early and blew it.
There was oral. We were leading up to it, and then suddenly she wanted to get out and get some... I don't know, we left the place.
You came, dog. It wasn't we were leading up to it. You busted a nut. You couldn't fucking...
There's nothing wrong with oral before the actual intercourse.
Yeah, you're not supposed to nut, though. Like, we paid for you to nut, or to bang it out, and then you didn't.
Yeah, I think I sort of burned through that money for the oral, but who knows? Could happen again.
Oh, brother. All right, so we're going to talk to her.
But she's on because of your encounter with her.
Yeah, she hit me up, like, all fucking pissed off at me or some shit. I don't know what the deal is.
She's a bit obsessed with you.
I'm trying to find her. I'm trying to find the tweet, right? Her text right now. Oh, there it is. I just found it. I didn't know what name I had her under. I got her under her government name. Look at me.
I don't even know her real name.
That's what I do with sex workers. I get their real names.
Does she know that? Due to the fact that you're a sex worker?
That's what I do with sex workers? Yeah.
As a sex worker, I'll need your real name.
Yeah, because I'm trying. You got to get them out of that headspace.
Ah.
You see what I'm saying?
Okay.
Get these chicks, they sex workers, get Get them out of their headspace. If they call themselves Shayna Love or whatever, I don't even know. And their real name's Stephanie. I'm like, yo, Stephanie, like, you got to break that shit. Because you don't want them to be thinking like you one of the customers.
She and I never got past that.
There was never even asked.
No. That was a wall I did not climb.
What were you saying? So hung young. So hung young. Sorry I came so fast. How long did it take you to bust?
Let's see, with the oral.
You bitch.
I was playing with her breasts, got a little excited. Maybe 4 minutes?
Oh, my God.
5 minutes.
Oh, man.
I was just trying to keep things moving.
Yo, and you know he tagged a good 2 minutes onto that shit, y'all. Lying like a motherfucker. All right, well, let's play a song. Come back with Hung Young Terrorist. I am Hung Young. You can follow her at I am Hung Young Terrorist. H-U-N-G. And got that. What Would You Do? The news and more here on the All Out Show. Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Hey. We are here with everyone's favorite Hung Young, everyone's favorite comedian / call girl. What's up, Hung Young?
Hi, Jude.
How you doing?
I'm good. It's so awesome to be back here on the show with you. All I had to do was send you a mean text. I see how it works now.
Well, it was more than that. It was more than just a mean text. So, yeah. These texts from you that are borderline fucking manic. It's like some of them will be really happy, and then other ones will be fucking crazy.
I don't have any in between, Jude. Do you?
Yeah, I'm like chilling. I don't fucking let me read the last text. First off, what are you doing out in New York? You getting money? You doing comedy or you tricking? Are you like
I'm looking for a spot to live, an apartment to live, because when I've been coming out here bi-coastal before, I had to pay rent at my old apartment that you refused to come to where I blew John. But having to pay for that and hotels in New York at the same time, like, I'm just not making that much money. I only have like one main client. So what I'm gonna do is crash at my parents in Beverly Hills for like 10 days of the month, and I can only stomach that knowing I'll have a spot out in here in New York, because there's like a lot more stage time here for comics, although people are saying LA is where it's at now that it's getting cold. But I don't know. I've never lived in New York through a winter with money. I've lived here.
Wait, so you're gonna be staying at your parents? And you're gonna be staying at your parents and hooking?
Yeah, hooking from home. Yeah, man. Actually, I have so much to say, but yeah, like.
Do they know? Are you like, hey?
They don't know. Actually, my mom and I are working really hard.
Fuck this old man for money.
We're working on a relationship. My mom wants me to stand up for myself more and stuff. Like, she asked me if I had a good vibrator, actually. She's really getting in there these days. She thinks I work at a she thinks I work
vibrator?
For a writer as a personal assistant. Yeah.
Well.
But anyway, you know, you don't want to call yourself a comedian, Jude. You know, I remember asking you to get up and do some stand-up, but comedians get a lot of leeway. Like, I saw how that meme got you in trouble. Like, if you put down you were a comedian, I don't think they would fuck with you as much. Because, like, comedians, like, they know they're just saying shit. Like, I feel like they fuck with you extra.
Yeah,
I
guess. Maybe. All right, let's talk. Speaking of fucking with, I got a message from you saying, let's see, by the way, real talk, fucking me on that chair was some bullshit. Would you like to explain yourself? Because I have my side of the story, too.
Well, it's confusing, Jude, because, like, you know, sometimes, like, last time I was on the show, I was like, you know, I'm very self-deprecating, and I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm just a piece of trash. And you're like, nah, you're a special lady. And, like, you know, but if I was really special, you would have taken me back to your bed. And it was just like hurtful because, you know, I do spy on you every now and again. And I see your IGTVs, and like one of them, you were like saying how, like, you know, when like a girl knows when it's time to fuck because like she gets, look at me, I'm like a little fucking sad puppy. She gets to go into the bedroom, right? But I never made it to the fucking bedroom, right? I never made it to your bedroom. And like, I don't know. It's like there's one other dude in LA.
I'll tell you why. What?
Because I run my mouth.
What's the other dude? What's the other dude that you fuck in LA?
There's another guy that I fuck a lot of guys, right? You know, I'm both you and him non-paying customers. Although, you know, other things make it very hot to fuck you, and I'm not just talking about your radio show. You know what I'm talking about? But like, so like he also grew up very poor, just like you, and this other guy like fucks me and doesn't kiss me, just like you, and it's just so funny, like. Y'all are like from very different backgrounds, but that's the one thing y'all have in common. I don't know. It's like I do like working towards something. I do like, you know, a challenge. But yo, that chair sucked a dick though. Like, you know, we did that chair and then we did your couch and shit. Like, I'm a Capricorn. I need luxury to really let go. Like, it's like I feel like when I came with you, like, I wasn't even sure if I was coming because I was so fucking nervous. I was so amped, you know, like your followers alone. Like I have a joke about this.
Yeah,
like,
I can't help it if you're in your head when we're fucking.
Yeah, but it's easier to get out of my head if I'm like on a bed. Like it's that chair didn't even have a fucking back.
No, we fucked on the footrest. What's it
that
called?
That was fucked up.
I forgot what it's called.
And you know when you really got me though, when you were like, look, act for me like how you act with your clients.
What?
That was when, yo, that cry sex was hot as fuck. When it's snot coming down my nose and shit, and you bit my earlobes, like it was like you couldn't resist.
Yeah,
you almost, I felt like I got so close to kissing you. You bit one of my earlobes. I can still feel the bites. One, and then you bit my other earlobe, and like.
Sounds terrible.
It's like, but man, I just like.
What are you talking
about? I'm just mad I didn't make it to the bed, man. You know, I'm just mad. About that,
I'm gonna be. I'll keep it 1,000 with you. You wear too much perfume.
That's it. That's so fucking sad.
I don't
want to
fuck you,
man.
And smell. I don't want to fuck you and be smelling you for fucking 7 days afterwards.
I actually had that problem with my John, so I do understand. Not this John, but yeah, I understand what you're saying. He wears a lot of cologne, and it's all
yeah.
The
quit pillows. Wearing all that goddamn perfume when you come fuck random dudes. Like it's like a dog pissing on a fucking tree or some shit. Like you're marking your territory. I'm just not having it. You're not gonna fucking stink up my bed. The last chick I brought to my bed was, I was like, you know. She didn't have as much perfume as you, and I still had to wash the fucking comforter.
I feel you.
Smell like Le Labo fucking Santel 42 or some shit like that. Like, ugh.
What would you have done if I just ran into your bathroom and, like, jumped on your bed? Would you have been like, it's over?
Ran into the, if you would have washed up first, good, fine. And then here's the other thing, like I end up with a yeast infection, so I don't know if I got that from you, but you're the last person I fucked.
Oh god, I feel so hot. Oh my god, really? I was the last person you fucked? Still today?
Yeah, I've been busy moving. I've been moving. I haven't fucked in a minute.
Oh
so
my god, you just made my whole life.
I'm putting
That's
apple
really
cider
hot.
Vinegar on my dick right now. Like it's fucked up.
I don't think it was me, but I do fuck a lot of black guys, so I don't know.
How does that relate?
I don't know.
Seriously, can I just
know,
tell you,
I don't
Jude?
Know black dudes are known for yeast infections.
Jude, half my income right now it goes to paying for these guys' food, fast food. It's just fast food, but like I've been supporting a lot of black guys, a lot of fast food meals I've been paying for. That's a side note.
You've become a fucking you're like a walking stereotype. You're bringing over the fucking the fucking 2-for-3s from fucking Checkers, and you're Ubering your way there and Ubering your way back, like
Checkers.
You're the white girl stereotype. Congratulations.
Yo, I love. So I was watching your IGTV today. I love how you describe your ethnicity, how there's like a smattering of English. I should describe my Koreanness with a smattering. I like that word that you chose.
A touch of. So you're fucking. So I'm not the only dude that you fucked for free. So like, don't act like I'm special.
You are special. I look.
You're actually fucking more guys for free than you are for money.
Of course I am, because the money's a good part. Although, John, oh no, I didn't make money off you, John. By the way, John and I are now friends. But anyways, Jude.
Yeah, he's the only one that could like pay full price for a prostitute, not fuck her, and then become friends.
What's wrong with that?
You got friend zoned by a hooker.
I like friends. Yeah, we're gonna
fucking lame.
Ride our bikes together. Hey, oral sex. I came in her mouth.
Here's the thing.
She tasted my semen.
She's fucking black guys for free and bringing them fucking Wendy's.
They're not just any black guys. I mean, they're fucking very talented black guys. Anyways,
they're probably gonna get you for a PlayStation 5 too.
Dude, I'm actually really worried that you're gonna have me.
She didn't say no, y'all. She didn't say no. PS5 on deck from her ass. See, you should be happy. I don't do you like that. I just slang dick.
God, I feel really.
I can't even
special.
Imagine you bringing me shit. Like I can't. You bringing me shit. I'd rather just work for it.
That yeast was not from me, honey. That can come from many things. You probably had some fucking bacteria in your drugs, probably.
Whatever you say. Hey, all I know is my shit smelled like a bakery.
Babe, your dick is really top of the line. We all know this. I mean, we all don't know it, but you know, I don't lie about that shit. It was excellent. I miss it. I really miss the elixir. But like, honestly, I'm afraid that like you're gonna want me to come out and like have your babies out there in Detroit. That's actually my biggest fear. Like, is that you're getting ready to like put me on that lake and like get me all barefoot and pregnant. I've had to come to terms with that. Like, you know, this I wasn't just like ready to like marry you when I first met you, but like I had to do some thinking. I was like, I don't know, you know, he sounds black. Are my parents gonna be okay with this? You know what I mean? Like, I had to do some thinking. So like, you know, I've come a long way.
Have no fear. I don't want to have kids with you. We good. How could you even think that? I won't even let you sleep in my bed. I won't even kiss you. I'm gonna fucking come inside of you.
I wait
till you're 3 miles away before I even jerk off. What's that?
Your dick has a tendency to get chicks pregnant, though. That's why you didn't. Oh wait, we didn't use rubbers though the last couple times, did we?
We did use motherfucking rubbers. Yeah.
I don't think
Trust
we did.
Me.
Ooh, see, that's
nah,
I like
I don't fuck
me.
Crazy raw. I don't put my dick inside of crazy raw. Like, it's already, I was see, already I, playing with fire fucking your crazy ass. There's no way I would go raw in you.
Don't you get turned on by ratchet bitches, though? Like, I feel like, it's like all my texts to you have been, like, so fucking sweet. Like, they've been, like, all, like, Molly amped. Like, they've been, like, I love you so much, Judy Blue Eyes and all this stuff. And then, like, the second I send you, like, a not, like, super praised text, like, I get all this attention. And it's, like, I wonder if, like...
John brought you up.
Did I?
Really?
Yeah, we was talking about you now. Yeah, it was in context about John, and then I brought up the fact that you was talking shit in the text and gave me a yeast infection.
Babe, like honestly, my pussy did hurt recently, but it wasn't from your dick. It was like from somebody else's dick, and I had a little monostat around, and I put a touch of it on, a smattering of monostat, and I felt. Better.
See?
So I don't know what out. Your shit's from. You probably honestly out. Sometimes like I'll go fuck a guy when my pussy out. Hurts and then my pussy feels better after. Like, so you probably just need to get some raw pussy.
You might have been walking around with a yeast infection and not known that shit and gave it to me.
Nah, my shit's tight, dude. You know, I didn't even start doing drugs till I was 25. My equipment's like intact, perfect.
Hey, look, yeast infections are just like sometimes it's just excess moisture or pH levels weird. It's not a knock on your fucking hygiene. I'm just telling you.
I'm not afraid of them. Like, look, when I got yeast infections, I tweet about them. I'm not embarrassed about it. Like, I would tell you. I'm just saying. I don't think it's from me. Like, my shit's a little Asian.
I literally had to
rub
my legs down with apple cider vinegar today. I literally had to rub my legs down with apple cider vinegar today. I smell like I'm walking around smelling like some fucking a side salad at fucking Olive Garden because of your ass.
Jude, you really can't blame me because, like, I remember even one time we were going to almost fuck, right? But then, like, you couldn't because, like, your dick hurts. So, like, don't act like it's me. Like, you have some ratchet bitches in your
different
Rolodex
guy.
That not just me.
888-742-3345. You can talk to I Am Hung Young. I Am Hung Young. She's going to be in New York. You taking on new clients in New York or no?
Absolutely, abso-fucking-lutely. Hit me up, please hit me up. Actually, I got so many fucking requests for shit after that last one when we raised funds on Sirius. Thank you, Sirius Shade 45, for that 400 for John. And yeah, like I feel like I really locked you. I feel like I got into your heart where I really got into your heart was when I handed you that Chris Pundy from my Indian client, because like I gave you that 20% like payoff, you know, the pimp payoff I gave you. Like, no hooker ever probably gave you $100 off of, like, what she made. Because I made, like, $400 or $500 from John, remember? And then I passed you that $100.
Yeah, but you got something from it.
Yeah, I got, but I gave back. The point is, like, you know, like, there were all these lepers in the fountain one time, and Jesus was there, and Jesus healed all these lepers, right? But they all left, and only the person that came
ecstasy.
Back.
You got, what are you fucking talking about? Like,
only the person, only the leper
didn't
that.
Give me anything. Fuck
I gave you
$100. Yeah, for fucking some ecstasy.
No, honey, the drugs are way separate, honey. Remember on air I gave you $100 because
remember.
You fucking pimped me out because you like raised $400 or $500 for me to fuck John. I gave you 20%. We talked about Iceberg Slim and his what he would take. Come on.
I don't remember. No. I don't that's how little it meant to me.
That's the PCP, honey. That's the PCP that you don't remember.
Now you just attacking me. Now you just trying to be hurtful.
I wouldn't. I was told to go in hard on you today, and I'm afraid to. I know you kicked a couple of ladies.
Actually, going hard. Yeah, I don't give a fuck.
You kicked a couple of ladies' clients out one time, she told me, so I'm actually a little afraid of you. I'm trying to do a nice balance.
Well,
ladies'
clients are fucking morons. Half of them are fucking idiots. Let's be real.
But I do. Do you want to come to New York and hang with me? It seems like there ain't nothing going on there.
No, I don't want to do. No.
Can I come meet your mom?
No, never. You can't meet
Can
my
I
mom.
Meet your sister in Glendale?
Yeah, you can go to Glendale and find her. She's
you got a couple
Armenian
sisters,
consulate.
Don't you? Different yeah. sisters.
Man, she knows way too much about me. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Hung Young said was upset that I fucked her on a chair. She was your problem is you want too much from me. Like you just can't just be happy with some dick.
What? So because I want a whole life with you? That's what you mean?
Yeah, you'd be like you'll be like what do you want me to do? I'll be like choke on that shit, take it all, and then you'd be like and then you won't do it. You're real selfish. You act like you want to do what I tell you to do, but then you just do what you want to do. You're a very selfish lover.
Do you remember me fucking bawling and snot coming out of my fucking face? I don't even think I've ever had that intense cry sex before. Wasn't that hot? Will you at least admit how hot that was, though?
Yeah, I do like tears. Tears do turn
me
on. Because
you knew I was real. That's what gets you off that real shit. By the way, side note, you ever type a hood into like youporn.com? Ever watch hood porn?
Nah.
Yo, it's fucking hot as fuck. There's this move called the Hennessy File Number 2. It's insane. The girl lies back, and the dude, like, the girl's, like, on her back, right? And then the dude lays on, is facing the other way, and he's, like, fucking her like this. It's Hennessy File Number 2, man. That's the shit. I've been typing some hood into it. It's fucking hot.
Have you tried Hennessy? Have you tried it on yourself?
No, we should try, you and me. Like, there's just, it's here's the thing, Judy.
We're not fucking again.
Judy, I'm coming to Detroit. Listen, I'm not.
You caught me high last time. You caught me high. I was on a good one.
You know, like, it's just that what you don't understand about me and about Capricorns, Judy Blue Eyes, is like, we really come to life in the bedroom. Like, you ain't really seen me fuck. You don't really know what I can do. Like, you see me on a couch and on a fucking footrest. Like, what are we talking about here? You know what I'm saying?
You're in your head too much. You're Capricorns are in their head too much.
What's your sign?
Stop sign. Fucking leave me the
fuck. He said, "Leave me alone" on his radio show. I love it.
Let's go to the phone lines.
I've got Danielle out of Detroit.
Danielle in the
Hello?
D. Hey, Danielle.
Hi.
Hey, girl.
Hey, what's up? Hey. I was just curious because I've been listening to the conversation, and I was just curious, like, you sound so pretty and young. I was curious why you don't sound like you're making that much money as far as, like, sex working.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Should I drop my monthly? I'm surviving a pandemic and I'm able to travel and move and shit. My last place was $2,600 a month for rent. So, I mean, that's like, I had a 2-bedroom. I had one extra bedroom than Jude, actually. So, you know what I'm saying? I think Jude never
you
came
ain't
over.
Hustling like, enough. You just, you get one old dude that'll pay you a bunch and then you just stop and you got all those other days in a week. You're not committed to hoeing.
You know what would be so hot, Jude, if, like, you and I, like, if you, like, pimped me out and, like, but I was, like, your bottom bitch? Anyways, Danielle, you know anybody that you could hook me up with, like, that got any money? Because here's the problem, Danielle.
Well,
a lot of girls, they drive down the
do
cost
you post
of pussy.
Anywhere?
Well, what?
She wants to know if you post anywhere. She really wants to give you advice on your prostitution.
Oh yeah, you can see. All right,
man.
Me.
Look, she over here trying to fucking save your ass. All right.
Please save me, please. I'll take some more money, Danielle. Thank you.
I've got Alex in Jersey City.
Look, man, we already shouted out your motherfucking thing. People can get at you. You can go fucking.
Oh yeah, all right.
Commute to some dick.
Sorry, honey. I'm on some Molly and acid. By the way, I still got that acid, and it's fucking great. I right, actually one of that guy that likes to fuck me and not kiss me, like he came over the other day before I moved and he took one of those LSD pills and he cut it in half and he put it in his pocket. You know, he grew up real poor and then he was like, "I'm so sorry I stole your drugs. I don't do that anymore." And he handed me back the pill. How cute is that? I still got that shit.
No wonder you like me. I'm the only person that's not a total piece of shit or a fucking John that fucks you.
I think it was cute that he stole my drugs. I feel like it kind of brought us together. And then, you know, he admitted it. I told him he was good. He was surprised I wasn't fazed. He's like, "Nothing bothers you." But it's like, when you're on Molly and acid, like, not much is going to bother you.
True
you know?
That. All right. Who else we got?
Got Alex in Jersey City.
Alex, what up, man? Go ahead.
Hey, Jude. What's up, Jude? What the fuck is she talking about? The reason she got yeast infections is because she fucks a lot of black guys. Where's the connection?
I'm a comedian, my love. You know, I didn't mean to offend you. If you want a blowjob, just DM me, all right? I'll pass.
But where's the connection?
There is no connection.
Maybe she just fucks a lot of guys. I don't know. I'm trying to fucking lighten this one up.
Sorry if that was racist. I apologize. Apologize. You could stick your dick in my mouth. I apologize.
Never
I turned
apologize.
Him off. Wow. Oof.
Never apologize. All right, let's go.
Oh shit. Okay, I'm not sorry.
There you go. All right. Who's next?
Got Joey in North Carolina.
Joey, go ahead, man.
Yo, Jude, please do not fuck this bitch again. Like, I am serious. She is gonna like glue your balls to your leg or some shit when you wake up. I'm serious, man.
Oh, I see that. I don't sleep. I to be real with you, I don't even think I leave her in the same room by herself. Bathroom, that's about it.
Just when I hear her laugh, man, I can just hear the crazy, like, echoing out of her damn voice. I am serious,
dog. Bro, I'm second generation Wiccan, so I have a little witch in me. And that might be what you're noticing. I got powers.
Oh.
That's why I don't fuck with her, God. Man. That's why, real talk. That's why I don't fuck with her ass. Like, we cool. I don't try to.
He
burn
tried
no
to
bridges.
Fuck with my ass, but I don't take that. I don't take big dicks like that in my ass. He did try to fuck with my ass.
That was exactly the problem. You're like, tell me what you want to do. I was like, let me fuck your ass, and you're like, eh. I'm like, all right, like, you're not committed to this.
Here's the thing. It's like, you know.
Don't talk all that shit like you down to do everything. Then I'm like, okay, let's do everything. And then you're like,
I almost died on your dick. I don't even know what you're talking about. If we could just like have like a 3-second clip of what I look like.
Dick?
I almost died on your dick. Like, I was choking. I was coughing. I was dying. I looked like I had COVID last time I was on your dick. I did. I looked like I was weak, man.
That's not death. That's commitment. Like, if
I needed
not
a respirator
like that all the fucking time. You're not going in.
Wow. I don't know who you're used to fucking, but it must be like porn stars. I'm not a porn star. My hole ain't stretched out. I've had like two guys try to go in there, and it's never pretty. You know,
right,
it's never pretty. You gotta have You gotta have a small dick though. You have a small dick if you want to go in my ass. You gotta have a chode. You don't have a chode.
A chode. All right, let's go.
Justin, here in California.
Jess, what up, man?
Yeah, you sound like a real, real, real whore. Can you put a number on how many dudes you've been with?
Ooh. I don't know. Maybe like a grand?
1,000 dudes? No shit.
Wow.
Is that a lot? I don't know. Maybe it's less.
Well, it's not a little.
I never count. You know, I think I counted one time and I got like to 70-something, but I don't really know. 1,000 sounds like it would make sense, but I haven't really counted. I'm great at math, though.
We'll say 1,000. We'll say 1,000.
You know what? Here's what it might be. It might be like 110, because I think at one point I counted. It took me a lot of Johns to get to the one that pays my bills now, so I think I went through about 40 dudes, and then like beyond that, including cousins, like I fucked like probably 71, 72.
How many cousins have you fucked?
Let me see.
Two cousins?
That I can think. Two cousins. Yeah.
How's the sex?
Oh man. Well, so one of them I only blew, and he doesn't talk to me anymore. I wish we could. So I don't know. And then the other one, it's so weird. Like the other one, his brother, his little brother, he's cool. He follows me. He loves you, by the way. He loves you, Jude.
Tell him I said what up.
Great, great, talented
Eskimo
musician.
Eskimo brothers. Me and your cousin.
You know, I can still smell him sometimes. You know how like those smells, like you can recall them. It was like. And yeah. It's like it wasn't a dirty smell, but in my mind, it's got a dirty like connotation. Like every sometimes, like I smell the smell, and I'm like, whoa.
What's the smell like?
Smells like Zach Attack, you know.
I guess.
Shout out to Zachy, love you, Zach. He's here in New York.
Shout out to your cousin Zach. Yeah, hit him up. Maybe we can get some.
We
cousin
were so
dick.
Young. Does it even count? I think we were like 7.
You lost your damn.
I was 5 when I lost that shit.
How old was he?
Does that even count?
How old was he?
Oh, he's like a year younger than me, 2 years younger than me.
So you child molested his ass. I guess it's about the same age.
It's called seduction, Jude.
Oh my God. All right, one last one and we're done.
Gotcha.
I am Hung Young. She'll be doing stand up and hooking in New York. Go ahead.
E Rich in Chicago.
Yo, what's good? Hey, all boys to the side, me and my lady right here listening to y'all show, right? And it feel like y'all got a little thing for each other. I think y'all bullshitting because all boys to the side, I don't give a fuck whether she a hooker or not. If a motherfucker throws some good pussy on you, it's good pussy, right? You know?
Yeah.
So I feel like y'all flirting back and forth. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's kind of bogus. And I feel like she did give you the yeast infection, though. Me and my lady, shit happened, you know? At the end of the day, you said that you ain't gonna fuck her again, right? But I feel like you don't wanna fuck her again because she gonna throw that pussy on you, and man, you gonna be flying out to Detroit. for real.
Well, yeah, you're right. You know what? Because also Jude said he wasn't gonna fuck me after I sucked John's dick, and we did fuck after I. That was actually one of my biggest fears, is that I wasn't gonna get to fuck him after I fucked John. But I did. He did have me back.
I did fuck her. But to be real with you, I did a full tank of nitrous oxide before she got me. I was pretty fucked up. I did 20 pounds of nitrous when she showed up. And fucking was like, all right, let's see what happens.
So you telling me without the drugs you wouldn't be fucking in here?
Look, here's the deal.
Nah, this is
how I live. Don't do nothing. Drunk that you can't do sober. So if those are the rules, then yes, I would have fucked her. So I'll own it. Don't do nothing drunk that you can't do sober. I fucked her.
That's what's up. You want honey with it though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And like I like Hung Young. She's cool people. I don't like fucking her that much because she wears too much perfume. And
I won't wear perfume anymore, and then, by the way.
And she's
also,
always in
was,
her fucking head. You're in your head all the goddamn time.
Listen, Jude, if I was Armenian.
And you're a selfish lover.
If I was Armenian, you would wife me, wouldn't you? Because you like Armenians like a motherfucker.
When you were like, I'll do whatever you want, and I was like, let me butt fuck you, and you said no, I was like, you're a selfish lover.
Jude, after we get married, you can butt fuck me, okay? Is that good?
Nope.
All right.
We're not getting married. It's not going to happen.
I feel like that's a yes. Like, your energy is yes.
All right, man. All right, Hung Young. I still got the monostat or whatever the fuck I got going on in vinegar. I'm doing the monostat vinegar fucking wash on my shit. I swear to God.
Babe, you need my mouth.
From eight to noon, I smell like a fucking, I smell like Caesar salad or some shit like that. And then
it wasn't me, babe. You need my mouth to cleanse you. Honestly, I bring dicks back to life after spinal surgery. My mouth it works wonders. You're underestimating. I'm a one stop shop. You got a problem? Stick it in my mouth. That's all I'm saying.
You can follow her at I Am Hung Young, y'all. Coming up next is What Would You Do? That's where I solve all your problems. Don't go anywhere. Thank you, Hung Young. Appreciate you.
Judy, I love you. Thanks, John.
She loves me, but she be talking all that shit on the motherfucking, on the thing. I wasn't going to say shit by Hung Young. Yeah, I wasn't going to say shit to her. But she just blasted me while I got a yeast infection. So I was like, nah, man, we're gonna have to talk this shit out on the air. Can't be blowing up my fucking phone, saying I'm a dick.
I'm surprised you had sex with her again after my penis was in her mouth.
I didn't kiss her. All so
right. Okay.
If you would have put your dick in her, then I wouldn't have put my dick in her vagina.
Well,
so technically, I guess my dick was her mouth, but you brush your teeth every day.
I do.
I mean, she does too. You know what I mean? And the pussy is like a self-cleaning oven.
Wash me all the way out.
Yeah. Still wouldn't kiss her though. Not after your dick's been there. No way.
All the way there. Yep.
No way. John, you should have smashed. She's got a good pussy.
Hey, who knows? She's coming back to L.A. soon. Go for a bike ride over Beverly Hills. Go up to your parents' place.
That's when you lost. That's when you lost. I don't know. Let's go for a bike ride. Just have her over to your motherfucking room and have some drinks and fuck, son.
That's not off the table.
And if she brings me up, be like, stop talking about his ass. Check her.
Of course. She's obsessed with you, by the way. So for me to actually think about sex when she wants to talk about is you.
You tell her to shut up about it.
I kind of did once. Like, listen, I'm not at work. I don't need to talk about this right now. I mean, this is
insane. You got to be like, dog, quit fucking talking about this motherfucker. I don't want to hear about him no more. Just say that shit.
She wants to know about what I know about you. And I'm like, oh, shut up. Stop.
You're not direct enough, man. You got to be checking these chicks, bro. That's your problem. You got to check them.
Ugh.
They want to be checked.
With her, I would agree with that.
Nah, all girls want to be checked.
She needs a lot of checking.
People, girls will be testing you just to see if you're going to check their ass. And if you don't, then you're a fucking bitch in their head, in the back of their head. They just fucking, they log that shit in their head. Like, look at this old bitch made motherfucker. I did all that. He ain't say a fucking thing. Check these chicks, man. It's good for everybody.
Well, and it looks like you've got a future wife. You got a family and hung over there if you want to pull that trigger.
No siree, Bob. No siree. I did like that she wasn't a fucking cult. I find that attractive. And I do like fucking hookers for free. I like that. But
she's got it all.
I would have took her to the bed if she wasn't dumped in fucking perfume. Smell like fucking old school Polo. They came over smelling like the green bottle of Polo. I'm like, what the fuck, son? It's like I'm fucking my uncle. All right, we're gonna play some music. Come back. What time is it right now, John?
It is 2:10 Pacific.
All right. Hey, do you got a problem? Here, put the little fucking little. We'll do the intro right now.
All right. Oh, that's the wrong one. But this is
that's
the
right. Cool. We can wait.
Oh. Oh, boy. And, of course, I deleted it with my slippery fingers. See? Well, it's fine, but...
I don't mind silence on the air. I like that shit. It makes people appreciate when you fucking say something. So don't get all nervous. Just fucking get this shit ready.
Pregnant pause.
Can you hear the guy in the fucking doing work on the house next door?
There's something going on over there for sure.
Yeah, he's fucking putting on a roof. Every time I go outside, I feel more and more emasculated. Like, this guy really knows how to, like, he was ripping apart his porch. Now he's putting a roof on his fucking house. Like, he's a real man. Like, I just feel like a fake man. All I can do is rent real men to come do shit to my house, or else I'll ruin it. Did you find it yet or no?
It's playing right now as we speak. You don't hear it? Don't you hear that?
Oh, now I do.
Okay.
Hey there, how you doing, champ? Doing good? Fucking awesome. You don't need me. You doing bad? Guess what? I'm here for you. All you gotta do is pick up the phone and dial 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Girl problems, guy problems, kid problems, parent problems, job problems. I handle all your problems. All you got to do is call me up. 888-742-3345. It is What Would You Do? It's coming up next. 888-742-3445. Or wait, I don't remember the number.
That's
888-742-3445. Shade 45. Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
It's like a ray of light beaming down knowledge from the heavens above.
What would you do? Need advice?
Call us up right now.
Now. 888-SHADE-45. What would you do?
On SHADE-45.
I'm here to help you. You got a problem, call up right now. Girl problem, guy problem, work problem, kid problem, any type of problem, call me up. I got you. 888-742-3345. Let's go.
Got Sam Cape Cod.
Let's go.
Hey, so my kid's mom's in jail, and she's asking me to send her a lawyer, and I don't really want to do it.
What's she in jail for?
She got an OUI like 2 years ago, which I paid for that lawyer, and then she got caught driving on a license 4 times in the last like 9 months, and it's pretty peaceful without her around.
Well, there you go. You just answered your own question.
All right.
Sounds like she's a perpetual fuck up that doesn't appreciate you looking out for her. I guess the main thing is how is your child going to be affected by her not being in your life?
He's fine. Me and my parents helped me out. I got him. Like, she's just bugging me to like send, because I got a good lawyer. She wants me to send my guy, and I'm like, one day I'm going to need him, because they're going to say I hit you. You know what I'm saying? And that'll be a conflict of interest.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, don't do that. Yeah, yeah. I didn't. You didn't even say that part. I thought she just wanted lawyer money. She ain't got a job or no shit.
I think she's got a bunch of that unemployment money, but I don't really know.
Yeah, tell her to find her own fucking lawyer, and tell your lawyer that since he's representing you, that he can't. It's a conflict of interest.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Fuck her. She got all that COVID money. Get that shit and get you a lawyer. Lawyer up. She'll be out in a couple fucking weeks. She'll be fine. She's going to be pissed off at you. But, hey, enjoy the peace. Who's next?
Rory in Missouri, I think.
Rory in Missouri.
Yo, I need your advice, bro.
What's the problem?
So, nah, it's not a problem. I'm trying to close the deal on this threesome with my wife and a mutual friend, yo. Like, we close.
Did you call before?
Nah, never.
Okay, all right. Someone else had the same thing with a wife and a mutual friend. Okay, so what's the problem?
Like we both married couples, so, like, I'm cool with her husband, so, like, what? Do I ask the husband to finish, you know what I mean, to make this shit link? Because I know my wife, once she gets drunk, she'll be on board, because she get that lesbian vibe when she get drunk. So
is she gonna wife? Are y'all gonna wife swap, or is he just sitting this one out?
That's what I'm saying. I don't know. Like it could be any one of the above, bro.
I don't know. Are you cool with the husband?
Yeah. That's the thing. I am.
All right. So I would talk to him, or have the woman talk to have his wife bring it up and see where he's at. See if he's into wife swapping.
That's what I'm going to do. Next time we get drunk, I'm going to probably just start, you know what I mean, leaning towards that side in front of everybody. So it ain't no secrets. You know what I mean?
It's not a bad idea. Or you can even just do it one-on-one. Like, if you guys are ever hanging out, be like, hey, my wife finds you attractive. Gas them up. You know what I'm saying? My wife finds you attractive. Would you be into, like, possibly trading? You know what I mean?
That actually might work out better. You're right.
You know
about
what
that.
I mean? Like, it kind of gasses his ego. He feels less threatened. He feels like he's doing some conquest shit because your wife finds him attractive. You know what I mean? Play it that way. That's how I would do it.
Oh yeah, it's going down, yo. I hope I could call back and let you know.
Yeah, we'll get your we'll put you on hold and take your number and see how it does go. All right.
I appreciate that, brother.
My man. Good luck to you. Yeah, I think that was it. That just came to me. Play to a motherfucker's ego when you can. Especially when it comes to the girl, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you're going to put dick in someone else's girl, you gotta bring a nice prize. Be like, my wife, she's been talking to you about you a lot, and she wants to sleep with you, but I don't really feel comfortable unless, you know, we swap. So what do you think? Bam. Then suddenly he's the one that's doing you the favor. You know what I'm saying?
Sounds like Inception. Planting ideas.
Yeah. Straight up. Straight up.
Got that Angel TK in Detroit.
Angel, what up?
Hey, I just have a question for you.
Go ahead, lay it on.
It took me 4 years to get to the point where I'm 100 with my man.
Okay.
I'm still legally married to my wife.
All right.
I was only with women for 22 years until this man somehow got my attention.
Yep.
And I'll tell you what.
Tell me.
I love him with everything I am, and I am definitely 100 with him now. Right. But I wasn't for almost 4 years. Now him, he's been 100 from the get.
What do you mean?
I met him
you
at
haven't
five...
been 100 with his ass. You've been fucking your wife this
I found
whole time.
Loopholes, loopholes. No, hell no. That crazy bitch tried to kill me. No, I've been 100. I always found loopholes. I found loopholes to fuck somebody else. I found loopholes to do this. I found loopholes to do that. I never lied to the man. But I've always
but you
found
lied
loopholes.
By omission.
I'm the queen of loop. I'm the queen of loopholes.
So you just
he told me not to fuck my ex no more, which was a woman.
Look,
he said
you're a piece of
on
shit.
February 28th. He said I'm a piece of shit.
You a piece of shit.
No, I'm 100
Listen
with
to me.
Him now.
Listen
and he
to
wants
me.
To you, marry me.
You a piece of shit. Right?
I was a piece of shit. I was.
Okay, so you don't have to continue being.
But I was.
So your behavior was shitty, right? You can admit that, right?
Oh, fuck yeah, it was. It was horrible.
Your
he
behavior
didn't deserve that.
Well, whatever. Never tell him. Okay?
He already knows. I already did.
You dumbass selfish motherfucker.
I won't lie to the man. He asked me outright, and I will not lie to the man. I've never lied to him.
He asked you outright. Okay, I understand that. I get it. But even this, like, look, man, if you're gonna do all this cheating and shit like that, keep that shit to your fucking self.
I ain't going to do that no more. That's
well, I'm saying moving forward, this is not just for you. This is for everybody listening. Like, if you're gonna be doing cheating and shit like that, just keep it to your fucking self, because you go fucking admitting it, then you just destroyed the confidence in the relationship. What motherfuckers don't know won't hurt them, especially if you're going to change your behavior.
I can't believe that this man has stuck with me for almost 4 years.
It sounds to me like you got to do some forgiving
of yourself.
And he's been loyal.
He's been loyal.
What's your problem,
it's
then?
Crazy.
Like, I don't
know.
Like, what's your problem?
You know what? I didn't know. You know what? I always thought, you know, he can't be for real. He can't be for real. Man, he's 20 years younger than I am. He's out there fucking. I'm way up north in Michigan. He's down in Detroit.
She's just bragging. You're just bragging, dude. You haven't even. I don't even know what your problem is. You caught up. Bragging that you fucked all these other dudes, that you got this super fucking loyal guy, that he's 20 years younger. And what is your problem? Bring her
up. My problem is I'm still legally married to this bitch that
so
I could not
divorce.
Be able to find an address on. I can't find an address on her. She went to jail for trying to kill me and my son. I haven't been able to locate her. Believe me, I haven't even seen that bitch since May of 17. It's in court. I want
get a motherfucking
gone.
Hire a private eye.
I be married.
Hire a private eye. He'll track her ass down.
You know what? I need a skip tracer. Not no private eye. I've already done that route. They can't find her either when she got out of jail. I'm telling you what? I need a skip tracer. Because
isn't there? Don't they
flat.
Got some fucking? Don't isn't there like some legal loophole if a motherfucker bails on you after a certain amount of time, you can just fucking cancel the shit?
You know, I've been trying to find it because we were married way up in Alpena
lawyer.
County.
All right, let me talk to somebody else.
Chanel in Boston.
I never would have guessed that she was a lesbian based on her fucking pack-a-day voice.
That was surprising.
Fucking 20 years, she got that dude 20 years younger. I say just move forward. Don't even just have a wedding and then figure out how to fucking legally make it fucking happen. But let everybody know that y'all married. Who said you need the law to fucking say that you're married? Tell people that you're married. Marry that 20-year-old motherfucker that wants to be a stepdad. All right, go ahead.
Chanel in Boston.
Hey, Chanel.
Hi.
You already sound less annoying than the last girl. All right, go ahead.
So my question is, boyfriend and I have been together almost 10 years. Mm-hmm. I am not getting any younger, ready for kids, ready for marriage, but he's not quite
Dump
there
him.
Yet.
Dump him.
Dump him. Okay.
Dump him. 10 years?
Yeah.
10 years?
He told me next year, though. So it's like,
did he tell
like,
you next year? Is this the first time
year?
He's told you next year?
No.
Why don't you be like, look, man. All right, so you got 10 years in this. So you, and he's going to, all right, so you're going to get engaged in a year and then you're going to get married when?
I would like to get married, you know, at least a year after the engagement, but I'm not in no rush, but I do want
so
kids. I want
that'll
kids.
That'll make you 32?
Yeah, I'm already 32.
So that'll make you 34?
I'd rather have the kids first. Yeah.
Does he have any objection to having kids first?
He wants to be able to take care of me because he dislocated his knee this year. So he wants to be able to take care of me with a fully healed knee.
there's so he never wants a good to be there time. For me while with the pregnancy.
Yeah, there's never a good time. That's bullshit.
Okay.
That's bullshit. I put the screws to his ass. Be like, look, man, I don't care. Knock me up. We'll make it. Do you want to be with me or not? I want to have some kids. It's been 10 fucking years.
Okay.
Here's the thing. This is what's not fair. This is the dope shit about women. You get to make babies. There's nothing more magical than that. You create life. Here's the shitty part for women. You got a ticking clock inside of you that makes it where you can't make babies after a certain amount of time.
Yeah.
So you got magic, but magic runs out. And you can come multiple times and you have better orgasms than us. But so you got all those things going for you. I think it's dope that you're embracing motherhood, and I think he should embrace that shit too. It's been 10 fucking years. How old is he? 30 something?
31. He just turned 31.
Look, he's probably a bit more immature than you, but you gotta really let him know. Be like, look, man, I don't got. You start getting up there in age, man. You risking it with the kids. You might have some kids that ain't all the way right. You know what I mean? Like you want to have young, healthy kids. Like. And you
want to
have
energy.
Yeah, I
don't want to be 35 with my first child. So.
Yeah, sitting there trying, having to go to fucking doctors and shit, trying to, because you can't get knocked up regularly and shit because you waited too fucking long. Why don't you do this? Why don't you just do this? Be like, look, we're not gonna try, but we're not gonna not try. So he just fucks you and nuts in you and sees what happens.
Okay.
I think that's a good and whatever happens, happens. And it catches ass when you're ovulating. You know what I'm saying? Bam. That way he doesn't feel as pinned in, but be like, look, man, we gotta move forward with this shit. We gotta move forward with this shit. We don't have to do it, but let's just let nature take its course. Boom. See if he got some swimmers or not. Who else we got?
Got Black in Vegas.
Black, what up, though?
What's good, Jude? Hey, man, quick question for you. Came out of a long-term relationship like 2 years ago, broke up with the chick, went online, started getting bored, started talking to this chick from Thailand, decided to take my ass out there, you know, met up with her, smoking hot girl, you know, bomb pussy, everything was straight. Got back, had plans, you know, plans on bringing her back to the States, got back and met a chick from out here, man. So met this girl, you know, nice girl, good family, you know, good job and everything like that. I'm asking, what the hell should I do? Should I stick with this smoking hot young girl from Thailand or keep it real and keep it with this girl from the States?
It seems like it would be easier for you to... A lot of mail order motherfuckers, I'm not saying she's mail order, but like, you know, sounds to me like he was on one of them types of sites.
Yeah.
A lot of times, those women, they want a family. They know what they want. They want a family. They want a better life. They want all that shit. The downside is is there a Thai community for her to be around? Is she going to be fucking bored? You know, like...
Right.
Is she going to be able to cruise around? The upside is, with the other girl, is she's from here. And I don't know, what do you want for the future? You want kids and all that shit or nah, or what?
Yeah, I'd like to get some kids. You know, the one from here is a little bit older, so she's running out of time.
Does she want kids too or no?
Thailand, she's already got two.
So does she want more is the question.
I'm not thinking so. I think she's going to keep the two that I got and have me come in as, you know, the stepdaddy.
Do you want that or do you want to have your own seed continue on?
You know, honestly, I'd like my own seed, but I would
take
care of it.
Well, then you just answer your own question.
Right.
Talk to her. Be like, hey, look, man, I'm down to lock it down with you, but we got to have some more kids. And if she ain't okay on the same page, be like, hey, I get it. That's cool. Good luck. Go find somebody to take care of these kids. Take care of the kids.
Right. So make the kids the final decision on it.
That's what you want, right? That's what we're here for. We're here to mate and fucking make kids. And some people are cool being stepdad. It sounds like you don't want to be that. So go with the bomb pussy that wants some kids.
To Thailand, you know, but bring her out here, then, you know, 15 years from now, she's fucking other dudes. Yeah.
The other chick could be fucking other dudes for all you know 15 years from now. You don't know. Nothing's guaranteed.
Right, you're right.
Does the Thai chick want kids? Right.
Oh, yeah. She wants the whole family. Mom's always already talking about coming out here.
Yeah, so, man. Like, yeah. Oh, yeah. She's gonna. Yeah. That's the one. You just be careful about that whole fucking having to sponsor the whole fucking family. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I already saw that light coming. Yeah, that's for sure.
So yeah, watch out for that. So she might not even be. Be careful with that one too.
Right. Right. I just don't want to string them both along for so long.
Well, maybe neither one of them is right for you. If OG is trying to get her whole fucking family like on board and shit, is she asking you money for her folks or anything like that?
Not for her folks. I bought her a little scooter while I was out there, little bike and shit when I was out there, but that was it.
All right, so she's not trying to like get you. She just wants.
No, she's not in my pockets.
All right. Okay, so it's like a baby red flag. It's not a giant one. I think the bottom line is, yo, like, if you want to have kids, go with the chick that wants to have kids.
Okay.
That's what I would do.
Yeah, it makes more sense. Think about the kid. Yep.
Yeah, that's what we're here for.
All right.
People be forgetting that shit,
appreciate
man.
You,
like,
man.
We here to multiply. Like, we're here to have kids. You find me and then your children. And like, look, there's a lot of good stepdads out there, and that's cool if you want to just be the stepdad. But it sounds to me like he didn't want to just be the stepdad. It sounded to me like he wanted, to have his own seeds.
He bought the hot lady in Thailand a scooter.
What's that?
He bought the hot lady in Thailand a scooter.
Yeah. That's cool. I'm sure she uses the fuck out that scooter, man. I seen fucking Anthony Bourdain. That'd be on scooters out there.
That's right. Zipping around.
Like buying her a motherfucking car, dog. Fucking doing the most on a Vespa or whatever the fuck she's driving. All right, give me someone else.
Got John in Atlanta.
John in Atlanta.
What up, Dojo?
Man, you got it, doggy.
Long time listener, first time caller, man. John gave me instructions. Not
okay.
To get on the phone and blah, blah, blah. But yo, so I'm a truck driver, right? And my old lady, man, she's always giving me these assumptions that I'm cheating on her. She sits home and watches, you know, Jerry Springer and, you know, dirty TV all day. You know what I'm saying? I come in after a couple weeks of being on the road, and she's always giving these assumptions that I'm cheating on her. She has this feeling. And I ain't never, I've had plenty of chances, bro. You know, they got all kinds of websites you can.
Let me ask you something. Do you think she's cheating on you?
No, I don't.
She's just paranoid.
Either that, or like you just said, you know what I mean? Maybe she got the guilty conscience.
Yes, a lot of times people project, you know what I mean?
What they're doing.
Yeah, people that call you a liar are liars. People that fucking, you know.
Now, I bust it up. You know what I mean? I send her home money every goddamn week. She don't work because of this whole COVID-19 thing going on.
Mm-hmm.
So she ain't been working in goddamn since March or some shit like that.
Damn.
So, you know, I send her loot home every week.
Right.
To help her live, you know what I mean? Her whole bedroom set. I paid for the two
How long
TVs
been with her for?
For 4 years, since 17.
All right. I actually
moved up from Atlanta to Massachusetts.
Just to be with her ass? Look, man, you're going to have to come to... She's going to have to, like... This can't go on, right? You can't, like... You don't want to keep... You don't want to keep being accused of this shit. So it's like, you guys got to come up with a plan to help her feel more, be like, look, clearly you're not comfortable. What can we do to help you feel more comfortable? Let her come up with some ideas. Maybe, you know. And then, and don't have it be forever. Like, don't have it where you got to call her ass every night just so she can feel, like, you don't want to be on that shit either. You know what I mean? Be like, I'll do this for a while to help you feel comfortable, but, like, this ain't forever, and you need to trust me at the end of the day. And so, and if she still can't get that shit, if she still can't get it right, you're a good dude. It sounds like, you know. Try therapy, and if that shit don't work, fucking peace. Peace the fuck out. It sucks, man. Like, it sucks when you get accused of doing some shit you don't do. It makes you want to go do it, because it's like, damn, I'm already being punished for this shit. I might as well get some pussy on the side. But don't do that. Just, you know, keep your head right. Talk to her ass. See what's really bothering her. And then that, and kind of, and you know, I'll be a little suspicious of her ass. Because anybody that's going that hard, a lot of times they're projecting. Who else we got?
Lauren in New York.
Lauren.
Hey, Jude.
What's your problem?
So this girl that I work with brought her man to my birthday party last month, and he literally, like, sliced somebody's face open at this party, and she's just making it mad awkward at work. So I just want to know if I should, like, confront her, or if I should just let it go.
Wait, her man gave somebody $150 at your birthday party?
Yeah, like, straight up made this dude look like someone tried to make a jack-o'-lantern out of his face.
What were they fighting over?
Just a stupid comment.
Jesus fucking Christ. Were they from the Bronx or some shit?
No, so this tall-ass white dude, his name, he was talking some mad shit. He gets drunk, he gets stupid, and he made a comment like, oh, the black guy always dies first in a scary movie. It was relevant to the conversation. And that dude just felt some type of way and just sliced his face open.
So he mentioned a black guy, wasn't even talking about him, and then got his face sliced open?
Yeah, he wasn't even directly talking about this dude. He was just making a general stupid comment.
Well, I don't even understand what the comment was. Well, regardless, so I wouldn't invite her to any more parties.
Oh, hell no.
And, like, have you spoken to her about it since then?
No, I'm the only person she won't talk to. Like, and it, because it was my birthday, she feels some type of way because she ruined my party. But we were, like, friends before that, so I haven't said a word to her.
She won't talk to you, and you didn't talk to her either? Like, yo, man, what happened? Like, your man sliced that dude's face open.
Nah, dude, she won't talk to me. She won't even look at me. Yeah, like, I've made some, like, little small comments to her, like, relative to work, just to see if she'll talk to me, and she still won't.
All right, well, fuck her then.
Weird.
Like, what are you going to do? You can't make somebody like you.
Yeah. It's not even, like, the fact that I want her to like me. It's just, like, we work in a close environment, so it's, like, we can either get over this or fuck it.
It's not, like, it sounds to me like you tried to get over it. I mean, you could try one more time, but you be like, hey, man, like, you can pull her aside, be like, hey, I feel like there's some tension between the two of us, and I don't want it to be there, and go from there. But if she doesn't want, if she still doesn't want that shit, fuck her.
Yeah.
Like, cause the bottom line, that was between her and that was between her man and the other dude, and you know what I mean? Like, that's between them two.
Yeah, and like I literally had nothing to do with it, and she just makes it so awkward. She won't even look at me.
Do you think she's mad at you, or do you think she feels weird about it happening?
I think she's embarrassed, but it just feels like she almost is, like, blaming me because her man's in trouble now, but, like, that's not my problem.
Yeah. I would. Yeah. Like, look, man. Since you do got to work with her, I'd give it one try, a real sincere try. I'd be like, hey, look, man. I don't want it to be weird between the two of us. Blah blah blah. And I would say some shit directly. Like, look, man. Since the party, shit's been weird, and I don't want shit to be weird between us.
Yeah, like, I can be professional. I don't gotta be her friend. I just, you know, like, don't make it awkward for me.
Well, you haven't directly fucking addressed it either, so.
Yeah.
That's on you.
Yeah.
So directly address it, and if she still wants to be fucking weird, then that's your answer.
All right. Yep. I'm gonna have to.
So get some ovaries. Get your ovaries up and go fucking talk to her.
Yeah, I think I'm about to be the big girl here.
Yeah, it sounds like you're scared. Like, quit being scared. Go fucking talk to her. Just be like, hey, man, like, it was crazy what happened at the birthday party, and it seems like it's been awkward between the two of us, and I don't want it to be like that. So how can we fix it? She might even be like, it's not awkward, da-da-da. And be like, oh, well, you know, you can give examples, and then if she still shuts you down, then ain't shit you could do. And if she's open, then who the fuck knows? You guys might be best friends. I just wouldn't be inviting the couples. I wouldn't be inviting couples out anymore. Gave old boy a $1.50.
Face slashing.
That dude must have been talking hella shit, or that guy must have been really sensitive. I don't know what it is. How old was he? Just out of curiosity. Is she gone?
No, she's still here.
How old was the dude that sliced the guy's face open?
Like 30, 32, 33.
Are you
something
fucking
like that?
Kidding me? Jesus Christ, dude.
Yeah, and the dude is like that he cut is like my age. He's 26.
Well, it doesn't matter. He's 32 years old, slicing dudes' faces open still.
All dude says is that he all the black guy dies first in scary movies because they were talking about scary movies.
He wasn't even talking about the black guy dies first in scary movies? Yeah, it's not even offensive.
Yes. Yeah.
That's like a
that's
fucking...
That's the start of the whole fight.
Yeah, man. I would holler at her. Black dudes do die first in scary movies. It's been a punchline. Shit, I remember there was. Yeah, it's a joke. I remember there was some movie with sharks. It was like a shark movie. They killed the brother in the motherfucking. He didn't even make it out of the preview. Like, they killed his ass in the preview. I was like, hell motherfucking no, dog. Like, that shit is. That joke is true. It's true.
Yeah.
I would talk to her, but it sounds to me like she's gonna roll with her man no matter what. But at least you gave it a good try. I wonder if he was like, ha ha, that's why, you know, or I don't know the context, but like, if he's just stating that fact, I don't think that deserves to have your face. He's gonna have.
Seems a little disproportionate.
He's gonna look like he was in a fucking gang fight. Shit. We got a couple cats we work with $1.50s on their fucking face because you know they've been through some things. This dude was just talking about horror movies and got his face sliced by a 32-year-old. Jesus fucking Christ. All right, give me someone else.
Pop in Texas.
Pop, what up, though?
Hey, what's going on, Jude?
Shit, chilling, man. Just fucking putting out fires.
Yeah. I know it. I hear it.
What's the problem?
Man, my problem is that, I got a person that I was in love with. Man, it goes back. She was 17 years old. And we married and I found out years later, that my daughter wasn't mine. It hurt me, man. Like, you know, I believe the whole time that we was together, that my daughter was mine.
God.
And the whole time, it wasn't mine. You know what I'm saying? My whole family believed that my daughter was mine, and it wasn't
When did you find out that your daughter wasn't your kid? How long ago was that?
I found out, it had to be like a year ago. I was working at a warehouse, and I had to do a screen to find out if the baby wasn't mine, because we was going through a divorce. Mm. But we had to go through the proper way of finding out if the baby wasn't ours. I went by the Walgreens test, and I knew when the results came back that it wasn't mine. But when we went inside court, they made me do a real thing, you know. And then when the results came back, man, the judge really he didn't know how to tell me, you know what I'm saying? Because she never showed up in court.
All right. So what is your problem now?
My problem is that I'm still in love with her. Like right now, she's in rehab.
You're still in love with the chick that gave you a different kid and all that shit?
Right. I'm still in love with her. Man, I love her to death, man. I love her to death, man. You know, right. And I'm still in love with her.
Does
and,
she want to
like
be
tonight,
with you,
man,
though?
I don't know, because she's messing with another guy, but at the same time.
All right. Okay, man. Look, man.
Okay. Yeah, I'm listening.
Simping.
I'm
you simping, bro. Like... I here's the deal. If she still loved you and fucking even with that lie for 13 years, you're willing to take her back, I'd be like, go ahead, man, do what you think is best for yourself and for the family and this, that, and the third. Like, people make mistakes, but she don't want to be with you, bro. And she lied. And she bold-faced lied to you. I would find a way to continue a relate. Does your daughter still want to have a relationship with you? She's 13.
Oh man, so. Man, my daughter. Look, listen to me, man. And just the God honest truth, my daughter was diagnosed with sinus infection in her brain, and she has a speech impairment. So
yeah,
she it's not her fault. She loves me to death. Man, she'll take me over her mother any day. It's not her fault. It's not her fault.
Yeah, well then look, here's the deal. Like, you and her, like, blood or not, you raised her for 13 years like she's your own kid. That's your fucking kid, all right? So, like, you got that. So I would focus on having a relationship with this child and moving on from the woman, because she clearly doesn't want to be with you, bro. And she's not trustworthy. And she's a fucking fiend. And the thing about fiends is they're selfish. They put drugs in front of your needs. So, like, if you try to get back with her, bro, you simping, man. And she's going to fucking dog you some more. I'm telling you. I'm not psychic. I'm just telling you, just patterns, bro. These are the patterns that you just laid down for me. That being said, like, you can't take you built 13 years worth of love with this child, man. All right, it's not your kid, but you still raise her like your kid. She still calls you dad. And I would just focus on having a relationship with the kid, man. You there?
Jude, yeah. I'm here, Jude.
Right,
can you
ahead.
Hear me?
Yeah, go ahead.
Man, hey, look, man. Hey, I love my daughter to death, man. She's 13 years old. She'll be 14 in April. And, yeah. Man, I love her to death, you know what I'm saying? And her mom, she's in rehab right now because of a drug addiction. And, you know.
Yeah, you're not going to save her, bro. You're not going to save her, man.
I know that.
All right. Okay. So I feel like we're talking in circles, man. It's done. Like, find a way to get over her and have a relationship with the kid, because she don't want to be with you.
With the kid. Right, right. Man, I respect that, Jude. Hey, man, yeah. Let me tell you something, Jude. I've been listening to you, man, for years, man. You know what I'm saying? And I do part-time radio, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I love you, man. I love your show. Man, hey, man, hey, man.
Thank you.
I love the way you do your thing, man. I follow you on Instagram, man. And
thanks, bro.
Man, you like one of my pictures, man. One of my pictures, man. It was a truck that I had. It was a black truck, man. And you probably can go back and look at it. It's a black truck with some black rims, man. You like my picture, man.
Yeah,
and I love that, man. Hey, man, it was a dope ass truck, man. I left this truck to this bitch, man. You know what I'm saying? Man, she got my truck. She got the look, man. I left it to her, 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 man.
You're killing me. You killing me, man. Quit simping, man. You're fucking killing me. You gotta quit simping. It's like I'm talking to John right now. Even John thinks you're simping. You gotta cut your losses, man. I understand you loved her for 13 years. I can't imagine the heartbreak you're going through. But like, she's a fucking dope fiend, cheating on you, fucking dope fiend, untrustworthy piece of shit. She's probably, look, this is the hard truth. She's probably blowing dudes in that fucking truck for drugs. The truck that you work hard to buy, she has no respect for herself, so she can't respect you. Fucking let it go. Take care of the kid. All right, give me someone else.
Okay. Cash in Norfolk, Virginia.
Cash in Virginia. What up, man?
What's up? So I'm at the restaurant with my lady, and her phone goes off. So I'm looking at her phone, and she looking at it, and I'm like, "Who?" I'm like, "Wow, that's my son calling you." So she goes to her call log, and she was like, "No, it's my brother," and immediately calls him back. So I said, "Call my son's phone back." So she calls it back. It's a totally different name than the name that popped up. My son's name's Kingsley. So she called. So she, it said King when it popped up. His phone back, it said Cash. Middle name. So I'm like, man, how is this not in your call log? And then there's no King in your contact. So she's like, I swear to God, it was. I don't know who it was. I don't know what it was. It's not here now. Like, should I believe her or let it go?
She's lying on you, bro. She's lying.
She lying?
Yeah, man.
When I tried to look at the phone when she was calling my son phone back, she wasn't trying to let me see the phone when I told her, and I had to pull it down. And I was like,
dog,
that ain't the same name.
Dog,
man, you bullshit.
Bro, she's lying.
Bet.
Not do what you gotta do. Do whatever the fuck you gotta do, but just know that she's fucking someone else.
Bet.
There's another dick going in her. Where's she at right now?
Right now she at her house, her mom's house, where she's staying at.
She's probably getting some dick in her right now. Come to terms with that.
Bet.
Hurts.
Appreciate you.
Hurts, man, but fucking deal with it. Yeah, she a fucking lie. She a goddamn lie.
Can we fit one more in? She's been waiting for a while.
All right, go ahead.
Jasmine, Lansing, Michigan.
Jazzy, what up?
Hey, so my problem is I'm going through a divorce right now. Mm-hmm. I was previously married. Didn't really have too much issues, you know, but it was a foreign marriage, so there was like language barriers and misunderstandings. So we
where is he from? Just out of curiosity.
He's from Jordan.
Oh, he's out of B, huh? Or is that?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a different kind of man.
Yeah. So, you know, so I got remarried, been married for like 5 years, got a daughter and stuff. And recently, I'm going through a divorce now. So recently my ex just came back into the picture, had an issue, you know, and, you know, I offered some help, and now he's, you know, he came to actually visit, and like he broke out his phone and showed me that he never deleted a damn picture or anything, you know, since 5 years ago. We haven't been married for the last 5 years, and he still has all that on his phone.
Do you think, let me ask you a question. Do you think he's had a chance to become Americanized?
Yeah. from before to now, like, his language has gotten better. He's understanding more things. It was easier to talk to him.
Does he let you drive in? Does he put you in the back seat still, or are you allowed to ride in the front with his ass?
Oh, I always rode in the front. That was the problem.
He ain't like that, though.
Yeah.
Is he cool with you riding in the front, I guess, is the question.
Yeah.
Well, listen to her. Yeah, did you hear that? Yeah. Uh-huh.
So that's my dilemma. He's coming back into the picture, and he's talking about how he still loves me, and talking about future plans already, about taking trips overseas to see his family again.
Well,
like,
look, here's the deal. You're going through a divorce, right? And you got a kid, right?
Yeah.
So why don't you be like, look, let's take it slow. Out of respect for my daughter.
Right.
So then you can actually really fucking, you don't got to put your daughter through no weird fucking shit. You're on the rebound. You're on the rebound, dude. You're rebounding. When did this divorce happen?
We've been actually Islamically, because I'm, I'm Muslim. So we've been divorced in my religion since last year. And I'm just waiting for my American divorce to finish. So it's been over a year.
So your last husband that you had, you've been divorced for a year?
Yeah, and I've already did my little rebounding, in between thing. So.
All right, bet. All right. Okay, so, well, here's the deal. I wouldn't rush into this one.
Second chances?
I do believe in second chances, but I also believe that there are cultural differences. I don't give a fuck what people say. There are cultural differences. Shit, I find them between me and just fucking white girls. You know what I mean? I'm Italian. They're like, why are you always yelling? I'm like, I'm not. I'm just Italian. They're fucking scared. And that's just between Europeans. So what I'm saying I would use this time, tell them that, because of your child, you want to take things slow and just really feel things out and see if those red flags are still there that made you get the divorce in the first place. Maybe
the only thing was I didn't think he wanted I have a kid from a previous relationship too. And at that time, I didn't feel like he wanted her in the picture. But
how many kids you got? Two now or three? Or
I have
two?
Okay. Yeah.
And you felt like he didn't want her in the picture?
Yeah, at that time. And he come to explain it to me better now and made me understand it was because he wasn't financially ready for all that, because she wasn't with me at the time. I was living overseas and came back to the United States.
Right.
And she wasn't really in the picture when I got back here. But
so how many kids you got living with you now?
Two.
Okay. And he's financially secure?
He recently owns gas station now, stepped the game up. And
go ahead. Pure Michigan.
And, he's met my kids, and, it's not what I thought it would have been.
Why don't you just take it slow anyway and see what, just take it slow. Take it for your fucking kids' sake. Take it fucking slow. Maybe he's the dream guy. He's doing his fucking thing. Just take it slow. See how shit goes.
I respect that.
You said it. Look, don't use what you want so bad to blind you from facts. All right.
Right.
I know that you want a family. I know that you want a man. I know that you want a father figure around for the kids. I understand you want all of that, and you deserve that. That being said, I don't know if this is a dude for you. Didn't work the first time. It might work the second time, but fucking allow shit to play out and really watch that shit, though. Look out for them red flags. I'm not saying browbeat old boy, but if you see some little fucking them same shits creeping up, they're not going away. They're not going away.
Mm-mm.
So good luck to you. I hope it works out between you and old boy. And if not, I'm sure you can find someone else that that shares your faith and that you click with. What they say? How is she there? Is she still there?
Yeah.
Well, was it Shalah or how you say it? God's will.
Mashallah,
assalamu alaikum. No, Shalah. Now, you old bootleg ass Muslim, you don't
inshallah,
even know Arabic.
God willing, yeah. Inshallah.
Inshallah, yes. Yeah, all right, there it is.
All right.
Whatever will happen, yeah, whatever. Inshallah. Fucking, let's see it. Let's see how it goes.
All right.
All right, there you go. But keep your eyes open, all right? Don't be blinded by love and by what you want.
That's right.
All right. We just saved the world.
Good work.
And it's only 6 o'clock Eastern. Mm-hmm. All right, don't go anywhere. We got more All Out Show to come. Let's go, let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shade 45. You listen to Shade 45. It's your boy Judy. Holding it down for you, COVID 45 in this bitch. Shout out to Hung Young. Follow her at Hung Young Terrorist, I believe. Is that it?
Yeah. Or I am Hung Young. Isn't that
it? I am Hung Young. Is it at I am Hung Young?
For Instagram. Yeah.
Yeah, her IG is I am Hung Young. Yeah. And thanks to everybody called up for What Would You Do? I hope I solved all your problems. Coming up next, the Boy Scouts are in some trouble.
Big trouble.
Big trouble for the Boy Scouts. Then we got another list of things that John will tell you. He's big on the lists. And a Bengali kid. Good news about a kid from
Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. You hear my dumb ass just trying to figure out what country that I'm like, Bangladesh. Fucking dumbass, fucking idiot. All right, yeah, we got all of that and more here on the All Out Show. Don't go anywhere.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
I have what appears to be a useful list here of 6 ways to train yourself to watch less porn.
This is for you, John. I didn't even want to talk about this, but this was, I picked this story just for you.
This could help me.
Because you're a fucking addict.
I don't know if I'm an addict.
You're a porn addict, John.
I think I may have checked in with a site or two this morning.
Yeah.
Get out of bed.
How many times you jerk off today?
There was one before a meeting, and then I was thinking about another one, and I never really followed through on it. So
just once today?
Just once.
There you go.
Once to completion. But now...
We start the show at 1 o'clock, y'all, just so you know.
So...
What about yesterday?
Boy, oh boy. 3-ish, maybe?
Jesus.
That I can remember. All right, so
that must have been torture for you when we had that sperm count contest. You didn't jerk off for like 6 days straight.
I'm in it to win it.
That must have been fucking crazy.
I hate losing.
Amazing. You hate losing. Yeah, look where you live.
It's not a total loss. You got a roof.
Right, tell me how to not jerk off. Let's not go down the fucking John's a loser fucking wormhole.
Well, this is a PhD, Megan Fleming, a sex
All
expert.
Right, Megan, tell me how to not jerk off to porn so much.
Now, this one I find a little strange, but maybe there's something deeper going on. Get clear on what you're trying to avoid. So I guess this
The fuck does that mean?
I guess this is a form of self-medication I'm trying to avoid.
You don't want to think about fucking...
I don't think so.
Loss or boredom or some shit, so you just jerk off.
I don't know.
All right, maybe. What's next?
Okay. Now, this one's key. Substitute in another behavior that has a similar effect. And they're talking about, you know, masturbation can decrease tension, anxiety, but exercise.
Go for a walk or something.
Yeah. Go to the boxing gym.
When I was younger and I jerked off more, I would do push-ups every time I wanted to jerk off. I would still jerk off, but it was a nice way to keep a little swole.
Yeah.
Keep a little pump going.
All right. And this one is ridiculous, but get a porn blocker on your computer. I'm not doing that.
Fuck that.
Yeah, I mean, that's... You can disable that in a heartbeat.
All's going to happen is you're going to start jerking off the weird shit on YouTube. That's the only thing that's going to happen. You'll just fucking find... Like me. Like, I had like a month of just jerking off to breastfeeding videos on YouTube. Fuck.
That can be kind of hot, though. Lactate?
Yeah, they play like smooth jazz. A fucking black chick with big tits.
Is that meant to be
feeding shit?
Is that meant to be sexy, or is there a reason on YouTube they'd have that?
I don't know what the fuck. You know, people. The shit with stuff like this is to be like, no, it's not supposed to be sexy, but we know what the fuck. You know what I mean? Like, come on. Come on. It's like that fucking cuties shit. They're like, oh, it's not so supposed to be. This is just supposed to show the sexualization of 11-year-olds as they have a close-up on her fucking 11-year-old twat popping.
Twat popping. Nice.
I didn't do it. They did it. I'm just describing the shit. I
still haven't watched that.
Shit, me neither. It's fucking... I'm not doing that shit.
Now, this one is not happening for me either. Join an online or in-person community. People.
Join a community.
Yeah.
And like Jerk Off Anonymous or some shit?
Well, if you go over to Reddit, you've got this porn addiction subreddit here. There are a bunch of stories.
Oh, yeah. We talked to one of them dudes from that shit.
Right. The NoFap guys.
Boring. Nope. What else?
All right. And also, well, this is kind of tied into an earlier one, but ask yourself what else you'd rather be doing with your life during the time you spend watching porn. But, I mean, it's not as though I'm sitting there for hours going down.
I know. I back in the day when I was, like, young and internet porn first was, like, really popping, like, I'd sit diagonal and, like, look at the fucking, have my head turned, and I would just go until I got a neck cramp. Which could be a long time.
Yeah.
So, but now I'm just trying to, I'm like a scene. Yeah. Find one scene, catch my nut, I'm done. I don't even make it through the whole scene.
I think I knew something was going on with me when I was younger and I had, you know, I don't know, 10 hustlers or whatever they were. And then I would sort of spread them out all in the bathroom before me. I was like, okay, look at that one.
Weirdo.
Yeah, that was too much.
Yo, that's how he does his fucking desk too, with the news articles and shit. You go in there, it's just fucking... It looks like a really bad serial killer's desk. Like, you got all this shit just spread out.
I can see the patterns.
You're like Charlie from fucking Always Sunny in Philadelphia. That's what your shit looks like. Whatever.
All right, and finally, look at what besides porn turns you on.
Look at what besides porn... All you're going to do is just start jerking off to that. Isn't that the problem? Like the escapism? Like masturbating too much? Whether you could be you could be jerking off to sunsets, but if you're jerking off to sunsets all the fucking time, it's still not good.
Well, I mean, for me, periodically, I'll just think back to an actual sexual encounter and I can get off on that. I was like, oh, yeah.
I do that too.
She was hot.
Yep. Remember how yesterday I was saying how like I like to have girls tell me shit that they feel awful about?
Yeah.
Sometimes I think about those stories they tell me. That's good. I like those.
Boy.
Ladies, if you got some shit that's really troubling you, some sexual shit that's on your mind that's hard to talk about, come ride my dick and tell me about it. I'll help you get through it.
That's the Jude therapy.
I'm the dick healer. Yep.
Does that make it worse or does it actually heal them when they confront it?
Nah, it makes them feel fucking accepted.
Oh. didn't
look. Can you imagine something that you just feel awful about, and then you tell me and my dick gets harder? You're like, oh, wow, it's not that bad. This guy doesn't find me repulsive. He's still cool to me and everything.
Oh, that's very healing of you.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. I'm here to help.
So it turns out that talking on the phone, people prefer that to texting, even though that some people out there are concerned it'll be awkward. But there's more of a connection rather than texting.
Isn't it crazy it's gotten to this shit within 10 years? Yeah, it took a decade. It took one, like it took a fucking quarter generation. Well, how long are generations? 20 years? Some yeah, shit
sounds,
like that?
Sounds about right.
It took half a generation to make people shook to talk on the phone. And then some people get offended when you call them. And like the people that get offended, you're not doing shit.
Yeah, I know.
You're not busy. You're watching some stupid fucking show in your house. You can actually pause the television. You're not that important.
Yeah, pick up the phone. Just pick up the phone. That sucks.
Hey, fucking. For me, it's just easier, too. It's like I just hop on the horn, call. Plus, I work on the radio, so I got a good voice. So, that goes for me. That works. Like, go with your strong suits. But, like, it's not like you're over here solving fucking the national debt with, like, a group of people or some shit. You're just probably sitting around doing fucking nothing by yourself. That don't bother me. Fuck out of here. Get over yourself. Yeah, and the fucking phone.
And the people who need to really set up these times where they're available, I'm like, oh, you're not down.
I do, yo, even, like, with these young chicks, I'm like, when are you going to be around? Let's hop on the phone.
Yeah.
And I got to fucking set a time for them.
Ugh.
I got to meet them halfway to get them on the fucking phone. I can't even just be like, give them a ring. Hello? What? Mm-hmm. That's if they pick up. Usually, I think right now if I tried on some chicks, they just send me the fucking voicemail.
Dick move.
If I haven't hit yet. Once you hit, they'll pick up the phone.
But it's absolutely true that phone calls bring people closer together rather than just sending these texts.
Yeah. Yeah, you can, like, look, man, like, we've gone over this. Communication is not just words, you know what I mean? It's tone, cadence, facial expression, fucking how loud you're saying this shit, like all of that. Hey, Jude, you want to go to a party? Yeah, that'd be great. Hey, Jude, you want to go to a party? Yeah, that'd be great. Same fucking sentence, two different meanings. You know what I mean? Like, so fucking, yeah.
Oh, of course.
I'm not for that shit.
I can instantly tell when you're bummed out by an idea.
Ooh, me?
Yeah. Takes about half a second.
What gives it away?
The way that you just said that there, just this sort of strain, like, oh, fine, John, whatever. Like, okay, man, sorry. I'll do better next time.
Just don't, like, all you got to do is don't pitch me ideas on Monday. Like, that's Monday, I'm just like, I feel like shit for some reason. Like, I'm grateful to be working, but I'm just, the groove isn't there yet. I'm not in my groove. And, like, you be like, hey, you want to do this? I'm like, excuse me. Oh. I'm like, nah. Yeah, sure. Fine. Whatever. Just, yeah. Can we stop talking about it?
That'll work.
Yeah. Whatever you say, man. Sure.
But can you imagine being one of these people who finds a phone conversation awkward? I mean, I feel.
Yeah.
I guess.
I told you my cousin, who, like, I love dearly and who's a young boss, but, like, she wanted, and this was her younger, I don't know how she is now, but like, this was like 10 years ago or some shit. And she was like, oh, I want to get on the radio. I was like, cool. I was like, cool, give me a call and I'll tell you everything I know. She was like, oh, I don't feel comfortable talking on the phone. And I just was like, welp.
That's a real problem.
Just wrote back, well then. And then we never talked. She didn't get into radio and we didn't talk on the phone. And that was that. Like, I ain't finna be having a fucking 40 minute texting conversation when we can get this shit done in 10 and really explore some ideas and shit. Like, nah. If you're afraid of talking on the phone, here's look, I'm not gonna criticize you, bitch. I'm just gonna say, you bitch made fucking scared to talk on the phone ass motherfucker. Just fucking, you just pick up the phone, hey, what's up? Say what you need and then listen and then talk. Respond to them. It's just like a regular conversation, but on the phone. It's not that hard. You can do it. Cats out here shook.
Sure seems that way. We'll
and that's who's
it.
Deciding my future. You know what I mean? Like, somebody is afraid to talk on the phone.
That's not going to work.
But that's why I got to fucking, you know, I got to work with that guy. You know, they're part of the whole pit thing. They can't even fucking, they're so fucking retarded. They can't even talk on the phone. Fuck out of here.
You get involved with chat apps or no? I still have people in my G-chat from the old days of radio. Checking with them now again.
I don't even, nah. No. I mean, I'm sure people was trying to do that shit with me, but I don't, you know me. I don't even be on my email. And I got this new shit where I got the iPhone 6. Yeah, I know, guys. I know, wow. I know. Catch up.
You're back there.
But I don't even hear texts. So people will text me and I don't, if I'm busy, I won't get it to, you know, later.
Ghosting people. Not on purpose. All right, so unfortunately, Sinbad has had a medical emergency. Sinbad. He had a stroke, but he's recovering from this stroke, according to his family. They mentioned this yesterday.
Sinbad? Is he going to get sin worse?
Well,
I hope he gets sin better.
Yes. They don't tell me how bad it is, but they're just saying a recent stroke, so he's on the mend.
Good for him. Good for you, Sinbad. I can't wait for you to get back on stage and crack corny jokes.
He's huge. He's still big. Sort of.
I know.
He?
I feel like Sinbad's big on like cruise ships. Doesn't seem like the kind of guy.
Sure.
Look, and I'm just, and the thing is this, is like I had respect for Sinbad. I really did back in the day. But he snubbed us, so.
What?
Yeah, Sinbad snubbed us.
Well, he's more like a family guy now, isn't he?
Well, he was doing his tour and shit, and we're like, you know, we all came up watching Different World, and we seen Sinbad. I've seen Sinbad stand-ups and shit like that when I was little. They're like, yeah, you want Sinbad? We're like, yeah, fuck yeah, we'll take Sinbad. And then he turned us down.
Well...
Him and KRS-One were the two people that turned us down.
Well, KRS-One.
So fuck both of them.
Oh. KRS-One's a saint.
He's got a Ninja Turtle nose.
But both these guys are sort of working the room clean, aren't they?
Whatever, Doug. KRS-One talked all that shit about no selling out. Then he did some shit with Puff Daddy in a Sprite commercial. Like, whatever, man. I was all, yo, I love BDP. I came up on BDP. I was so fucking offended when he's got songs about fucking 13-year-olds. We're the pieces of shit.
Well, he's evolved.
And it was because something Sear said in the fucking intro. Sear said something in the intro talking about fuck your little sister. Didn't say the age. And then he got up and left.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it was the weirdest shit.
Okay. I thought he just turned you guys. I didn't realize he left.
No, he got up and walked out. Okay. We're like, are you fucking kidding me?
That's bold. Well, he knew what he didn't like.
Yeah, he likes 13 and Good.
Day.
I think that's the name of the song. Or is it 15 and Good? Something illegal and good. He likes that, but he didn't like Sears rap.
I used to like those intros, by the way.
Yeah, yeah, I like Sid's rap too.
Well, again, I don't know how bad it is, but he's currently recovering. Same
bad. Yeah, hopefully he gets better. Even look, even though he was a dick to us, I don't wish bad on him. I will make fun of his sickness though, because fuck him, but I hope he gets better.
Seems likely.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll bounce back. But them strokes ain't no hoe, man.
No.
I know a lot of people that fucking strokes, they'll take out the toughest motherfucker, man. So hopefully he does get better. Real talk. Like, yeah, shit on him, but at the end of the day, I don't want to see anybody, you know, I don't want to see anybody sick.
Right. Half your face is paralyzed.
Yeah, man. I don't want to see that shit.
Yeah, that's not good. All right. Well, the Boy Scouts are still around, but barely. And they've just been hit.
Barely holding on. Well, because they started letting girls in the boys. They got this shit called Girl Scouts. Can't we fucking have anything?
Well, I don't know if we want this anymore. And that's because the Boy Scouts have been hit with 92,700 sexual abuse claims.
I mean,
did you hear that? Over 92,000?
92,000?
Yeah. That's hard to even understand.
That's more than teachers and that's more than teachers and priests put together.
What is going on there?
Well, you got some fucking suspect dudes taking when did that shit start happening? Over how long is that over?
Decades. This is because, you know, once they started to trickle out several years ago, then they set up these sort of services to ferret out people and encourage them to come forward. And now, I mean, boy,
man, that's rough. I'm not. There's, come on, man. You got, what is it? Let me like, I think we really got to take a look at this shit. Like, cause this has been happening since the beginning of time. Why do these grown-ups keep fucking kids, man? What is it about, like since forever, kids have been getting fucked by grown-ups. Why? Like, what is it in certain humans? It's fucking crazy, man.
They're damaged.
Is there a fucking gene or some shit? You know what I mean? Like, is there a kid fucking gene that you could look for? Like, what? He's got the fucking, you know, whatever. The PX helix. That means he fucking fucks kids.
Who knows? I can't. I'm glad I don't understand it.
I don't either, man. Like, but I'm just saying it's happened enough regularly across all fucking cultures. Do you know that, like, some, like, to this day, some tribes in Pakistan, like, the coming of age, the uncle fucks the goddamn, the kid?
I've like, not
when
heard
he turns
that.
15?
Male or female? Well, it doesn't matter.
It's a male. Butt fucks him.
I'd have to look at that, man. That sounds very strange.
I heard it firsthand from my homie that was over there.
All right. Well, that sounds very terrible. I think they should reevaluate that.
I'm not. Look, but all right. Let's focus on the Boy Scouts shit. So you got the dudes spending all this time with the kids, unsupervised, taking them out in the woods. It's fucked up, man. And the worst thing about it is like, the Boy Scouts was supposed to be like this place where kids could learn skills and shit. You know what I mean? Like,
hey, I was there. I know.
Were you a Boy Scout?
I was a Cub Scout. At some point, I said, fuck this." But I was a Cub Scout.
Man, we tried to be a Cub. We tried to be Cub Scouts. Our shit was whack as fuck. Our Cub Scout leader didn't teach us shit. I just remember going over to, like, I went to one meeting and she didn't teach us how to do anything and just put Karate Kid on and just told us to watch Karate Kid. And I was like, are you fucking serious? There was like a turtle string race. I'm looking at it right now, actually, from when I was a Cub Scout. And it was It was like a wooden turtle that you tug on a string. And I won that race. I won a fucking knife.
Nice.
Hell yeah. It's hanging up in the window right now. My mom's super proud. She's like, you fucking did it.
About the only thing I remember is the Pinewood Derby. We had to carve those little cars together.
See, that's how bootleg our shit was. We got rid of the Pinewood Derby and just had a fucking pre-cut out turtle with a hole in that bitch. Out of some fucking plywood, like fake plywood that you just pulled on a string. Puh fucking thetic.
Did you get a badge for that?
Yeah, we was old budget ass, fucking low rent Cub Scout. Shit. But like the Boy Scouts and the Eagle Scouts actually like learn how to tie knots and go live out in the wilderness and shit.
Start fires.
Yeah, you could start a fire. All the nerds was Cub Scouts or Boy Scouts. So what are they going to do about this shit?
Well, they're going to try to find a way to pay these people, which is going to be a real problem. Because it looks like the Boy Scouts, they've got about $1 billion floating around in various formats. And then other local groups have more money, but they just have to pay these people. And they're just going to have nothing left. I mean, they'll exist in some really pared-down version, but
I hate to be a dick, but how do we know that these, like, how do I know that this ain't a cash grab?
Because they have attorneys and other experts looking at it. I mean, that's all I can really say.
I mean, how do they prove it? Like, all of them are fucking telling the truth, but, like, I'm just saying, you know. They're like, oh, Boy Scouts paying out motherfuckers because there were some booty ticklers out there. There might be a couple dudes out there that's just like, man, I need some cash.
Oh, I'm sure that's part
of it. Fucking COVID shit is killing me. I ain't been to work. Fucking 8 months. Let me, Ron tickled my ass when we was camping in the pinery.
Mm.
Tickled my butthole. He wanted me to go look for sticks for marshmallows with him and tickle my ass.
And there was this really strange-looking stick.
And he said there was a stick in his pocket. Didn't feel like a stick.
Check out this pocket knife.
Oh, shut up. Half the people are like, you can't joke about that.
Well, the crazy thing for me is that,
what's that?
They knew about this stuff going on. So some of the adults there knew that there was some abuse going on, and they just kind of brushed it away and tried to, like the Catholic Church.
That's the thing, bro. You got to fucking, this is everybody, every community needs a self-police. Every single community. Whatever community you're thinking of, y'all, everybody, we, my community, your community, whatever community, you got to self-police.
I mean, how can you
gotta check that shit right there.
Yeah, how can you live with yourself if
Bob's fucking kids? Bob did some shit.
Bob's
with some
gotta
kids.
Go.
Fucking yo, Bob, you gotta go. He's the fuck out of here. Put the kid in fucking counseling.
That is twisted.
I get it. They gotta, even if they get rid of him silently, you know what I mean? Like they don't want to fucking scare everybody. Get rid of his ass silently. But Bob can't continue on with these fucking kids teaching them how to tie knots and shit. When they know goddamn well that Bob fucks with children, man. That's fucking fucked up.
Who we?
Yep.
Well, so I'm guessing
All Out Show is against kid fucking.
Nice.
That's been my stance for years now. Years.
I know.
I'm for the children. I am, bro.
I know you are.
I am. I think it's fucked up, man. Like, I think it's fucked up. They'd be taking advantage of these little ass fucking kids, man. It fucks up their brain, man. I know too many cats that got molested coming up, and it really fucks with them, man.
Oh, yeah.
I got family members. I got fucking chicks I used to date. I know I got homies.
I've lost track of the women I know who've got these stories. At first, it was
surprising.
I know a bunch
of dudes that got fucking molested, man. Like, It fucks with their brain, man. Most of them turn to alcohol and shit just to deal with it. Like, it's fucked up, man. Like, yeah. They need to cash these dudes out, even the ones that are lying. I just really honestly, man, like, there needs to be a group, whether it's the Boy Scouts or whatever, there needs to be a group that teaches kids how to go outside and be around nature and learn how to do shit and be self-sufficient.
Yeah, in theory, it's a very good idea.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, like, they just need to find someone that doesn't fuck kids to go do that shit.
That's a good start.
And maybe you get two scout leaders out there, so, like, you know, they can keep an eye on each other.
That's a good plan.
Like, me and you go out there, I see you start acting weird.
Right.
Doo-doo. I pull you aside. John, man, you was out in the bushes a while, bro. What's up?
Well, there was this squirrel. We had to go find the squirrel.
Yeah, see?
Yeah.
And then fucking stop it right there. I'm just trying to find ways to fucking make this shit work without... You dig what I'm saying? That's all I'm saying.
No.
Like,
yeah.
I ain't for this shit. It's fucked up. And, that's all I got to say.
We'll see what happens. I do have some good news, though.
Please give me some good news, please.
And now, time for good news.
So, I'm a little torn on how you'll react to this, but this is a good thing. I'm just going to state that up front. So, this teen out of Bangladesh, a Bangladeshi teen...
Hell yeah.
...has now won an award for an anti-cyberbullying app. His name is Sadat Rahman. He's 17, and he was inspired to create this mobile app to help young people report online abuse after
tell.
Hey, man, you don't know what it's like. I don't know either.
I do not know what it's like, but it seems to me that people have weaponized cyberbullying. Like, most of the people, like, I've been in trouble for cyberbullying 50 fucking times, and I haven't said shit to anybody personally, really.
Yeah, but you're not like a 13-year-old kid. I mean,
this
I can't imagine.
True. I'm just saying, right. Like... I it's tough, man. I'm not a child, so it's really hard to relate, you know what I mean? Like, where your whole world is online and then you get fucked with by people and you don't know how to stick up for yourself.
Yeah, and you go home from school when we were kids, you could just say, like, okay, at least we're done with that for today. But now you go home, you're getting hammered at home. I mean,
the worst is, like, when someone will call you on three-way and set you up. Yeah. That was the worst shit you had to worry about back in the day.
Oh, man.
This shit, they got screenshots, everything. You got to be savvy, man. You got to be a savvy kid. You can't say shit. So I guess it's cool that he came up with an app. I don't know if...
Well, here's, it's called Cyber Teens, and it allows young people to report cyberbullying confidentially, and then some volunteers will reach out and see if the kid's okay, and then see if the, you know, if they gotta escalate. You know, it's just it's an option.
The old scarlet letter. So anybody can just accuse anyone of cyberbullying?
Well, I mean, I guess I could do it to you, but in the end, they would find out that that was bullshit. So
maybe. I don't know. All right. Well, if it works well, good. If it doesn't, I don't know.
No.
But we have to figure out a way to stick up for ourselves moving forward. Like, I don't know what the answer is for this one. You know what I mean? Like I said, I'm not a kid. I don't know the answer. These kids are awful. They're vicious. And it's not like, and everybody's brave as fuck online. You know what I mean? In the comfort of their own home, they can talk a gang of shit. And they can team up on you and stuff. You're almost better off face to face, you know?
Right.
So, personally, I don't think I would let, like, I don't know. If I had a kid, I don't know if I'd let them online for a long ass time.
It would be tough, but that'd be a good start.
Well, just for everything I know about being online, like, I don't know if you're a fucking, you know, like even video gaming and shit, you're online. Like, all they do is talk shit to each other, you know?
I know. I was going to hang out with my nephews, and all these kids are in there screaming at us. I'm like, this is chaos.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like fucking Lord of the Flies in there. But there's no consequences. Like, you can't do shit to nobody because they're all in their house. So, like, I don't even know if I'd let my kid online.
Yeah.
I keep the motherfuckers away from that shit. I teach them how to do all, like, the computer shit so they're not, like, dumb. You know what I mean? But, like, psh, I don't know, man. It just seems fucked up to me. All the smart people in the tech world don't let their kids play on their phones. Think about that for a minute. They'll sell you some shit, but they won't give it to their own kids.
They know the risks.
That's like a dope dealer. He'll serve you some fentanyl, but he ain't gonna give it to his own people.
Well, just to be clear, other people think Sadat did a good thing. He just won the International Children's Peace Prize for this.
That's cool.
Got about $118,000.
Damn. $118,000
yeah.
In Bangladesh? That's like a zillion dollars.
So,
you know how much land he could buy?
He can do a lot with that.
Yeah. Yeah.
I could do a lot with that.
That's a lot of gin.
That is a lot of
your
gin.
Ass. All right. That was the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, y'all. That was the show. You can get your fucking All Out Show gear at All Out. At One More Jude. Go to onemorejude.com. And there's interviews and all types of stuff for you to watch. And All Out Show gear. There's even an I Am Rude Jude mug where you can walk around and let people know that you keep it 100. Thanks to I am Hung Young, HUNGYUNG. John Z. Matthews is a producer. Jade is our intern and our associate producer extraordinaire. Fucking handling shit. Keenan at Kylo Keen handles at All Out Show shit. All of the at All Out Show shit. And if you want to follow Judy, I post dank memes. Like one of them got blocked today. I had to take it down because I was shadow banned for, probably still am. You know what it was?
Something mildly offensive.
No, it was a joke. It was like, in Portland now straws are legal, or now Coke's legal and straws aren't, or some shit like that.
What?
Yeah, that shit got blocked. It was a fucking joke.
That's
like
nothing.
Fact check. Da da da.
Oh, that's absurd.
Throttled me and shit. I'm like, God damn it. So go to at One More Jude to see the fucking spicy memes. I got them spice. I got the motherfucking spice. That and more. All right, y'all. Have a good one. We will talk to you tomorrow.